So here we have some, what do you call it, Google IoT client, Tiny Linux?
Yes.
So hi, so who are you?
I'm Manish Pandey from ARM.
So what are you showing here?
So our main USP of this demo was to use mainline Linux kernel for IoT devices. And then the Linux, we are calling it as Tiny Linux, where we are thinking about something around 4 MB of RAM, which will run complete Google IoT client, any IoT client application. We have taken Google as reference here, but later on we can use any of the client applications. And we want to avoid DRAM completely, use only SRAM, 4 meg of SRAM maybe, and running on in any Cortex-A system. So it's not a very low-end microcontroller IoT system, but application processor IoT system.
It's the smallest ARM Cortex-A.
Yes,
A5 is
the smallest one in V7.
And right here is, what are you talking about here?
So this is the repository where, the readme, where we have kept the complete stack. Anybody can go and reproduce it with them.
So they can check all the software there?
Yes, and to show the demo. So I have a running, so our platform is not a real platform as of now, because we don't have any real platform with XIP flash, NOR flash, where we can do execute in place. So we have used a fast model, Cortex-A5 fast model, which is ARM simulators for any processor design. And I'll show you the demo. So this is our fast model. And there is an MQTT application. This is a C application which communicates with Google server, cloud server. Yeah? So to communicate with Google Cloud, you need to pass device ID, region, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah?
So I have written the command here, just our details. So this communicates through MQTT to Google Cloud, and if you see here at the cloud server, and if you refresh, so there is a hello world packet which has been sent to So the message has been delivered. It may take a minute or so to reflect here. So this is Google Cloud Server, where we have sent a Hello World packet using our stack. And the memory usage is 12 MB of RAM as of now, without optimizing user space, without optimizing any libraries. So we are hoping something for 4 MB of RAM for complete software stack running the application.
Cool. So it's not doing RTOS, it's using Linux.
It's Linux mainline, Linux. For
not RTOS.
No.
And what's the main advantage of using Linux instead of RTOS?
Okay. So this IoT system, IoT is very much fragmented with the OSs. Like, there are lots of OSs out there, like any of the RTOS, which are mainline, but the community support is not as big as Linux, so we want to avoid that fragmentation and use Linux mainline Linux kernel to just make, to get help from the community, because anything which we use Linux kernel, it will be like support from all across the world, and it has it will reduce the time of marketing the devices, because we have a community support for Linux kernel.
Are you maintaining that? What is your role?
So currently I have taken some work from Tiny Linux, from Nicolas, who is Linaro engineer, and then I have some more patches which I'm planning to make upstream, and there are there will be a tiny config which will be just enabling only those bits which are required for an IoT device.
Nice. So is this very exciting work?
Yes, pretty cool. I mean, we are really hopeful to make it a kind of reference software stack which can be used for any IoT device running a Cortex-A series of processors.
And in future, maybe there's going to be some other small Cortex-A?
I'm not sure about that. But
A35?
A35? I'm not sure about A35.
Something like that.
I'm not sure.
I need to check.
The Cortex-A5 is the lowest in the version 7 with low power consumption. So our main target is to reduce, to make low power consumption, which Cortex-A5 gives, plus avoiding DRAM completely. The power consumption will be, the power will be improved.